Hey guys, welcome to another Visual Basic tutorial. Last lesson, what happened was we made a program that allows us to read from a text file. So I have a text file with the contents Eddie 2500 Phil 360, and I click read from file, and it loads the contents of that text file, which was called score.txt, and puts it in the program. So make sure you have got this far from the last tutorial, because this tutorial is a continuation from that tutorial. Okay, so what we're gonna do in this tutorial is learn how to write into the text file. So the first thing we're gonna do is make some changes to the interface. Instead of a label, I'm now going to put a text box onto the screen. So delete label one, and I'm gonna drag a text box onto the screen. And this, the name of the text box is text box one. And I want to change the properties so that the multi-line property is changed to true. And once I have done that, you will find that you can drag the text box to make it bigger. Now the read from file button is still gonna be there. I'm gonna drag another two buttons onto the screen. The first button is going to say write to file. So click on that button and change it to write to file by changing the text property of button 2. So the display is now write to file. Now the third button we're going to make is called clear. And what this button does is it's going to clear the text box. Okay, so let's just check whether read from file works. So double click on the button read from file, and notice how it's highlighted label one. That's because we have just deleted label one. And what we want to do is change label one to text box one, because that is the name of our text box. So text box one dot text equals temp s, which is the string that contains the contents of that file. So run it, and if you click read from file, it works, but these two buttons haven't been programmed yet. Now the easiest button to program is clear, so let's do that first. So go back to your program, double click on clear, and what clear is going to do is simply clear the text box. So I'm going to change the coding for button 3 click to text box 1 dot clear and brackets. So basically all this is going to do is clear text box 1. And if you run it and you read from a file, you clear it, right? So the button is now gone. Okay, so now let's program button 2, which is write to file. Now it's going to have a similar structure to button 1, and the first thing we want to do is declare a variable called file num and use the free file function to find a number that is not taken as the file number. Okay, the next thing you want to do is open up the file score.txt, and this time the open mode instead of input is going to be output, and the reason is because we're outputting the contents of our program into the file. Okay, the third thing we're gonna do is use the print line function. So print line. And what this function does is it saves the string to our file. So the first argument is the file number, and the second argument is the string which is coming from the text box 1.txt. So everything in text box 1, inside text box 1, is going to be saved into the file, and then we're going to close the file. Okay, now let's check if this works by running the program. And so let's read from the file, clear it, read from the file. Now I'm going to add another two lines. Let's call it John 500. Write to the file, clear it. If you read from the file again, it's going to read the contents of that file, which is now containing John 500. And if you actually go to the folder where score.txt is saved, which you should remember from last lesson, if you double click on that txt file, it certainly does have John 500 in it. Okay, so thanks for watching the tutorial on how to write to a text file from Visual Basic. See you again next time.